why do you want me to do that? And I think of, and there's a song, and I think, and I resonate, music just resonates with me. So there's a Fred Hammond song, and it's called Please Don't Pass Me By. When we were kind of just talking about, you know, the other day about this, you know, what we were going to do today, and you were like, think of a scripture and think of this. And then just right before we got on, the song passed it. And I hear the song all the time. And it's just like, please don't pass me by, Jesus, you know. And I think there is an innate desire in us to not be passed by, because like once we have that relationship, and it's like it's so embedded, because our flesh repels the word and God, you know, but our soul, the deep, the inner cravings for us want God. And I think that's that push and pull. And that's what I've been feeling for certain. You know, it's that push and pull, like I'm missing something. And everything that I thought was out there is not what's going to have me fulfilled. And that song just like, and the song is, if you will indulge me, the scripture that's connected to that song is Psalms 42 and 1. And it's, as the deer pants for the streams of water, so my soul pants for you, O God. My soul thirsts for you, for the living God. When can I go and meet with God? My tears have been my food day and night, while men say to me all day long, where is your God? It's like, you know, the outside world is like, where's this God when you're struggling? And I mean, I think for me, especially these last 3 months, you know, I've had my challenges at work, as well as, you know, coming on the tail end of cancer. It's like, how can I defend God to the world when I feel like I'm just at a place of struggle, when I feel like I'm at a place of empty? And it's my soul, but my soul is crying out because I'm not filling my soul with God and with the word. I'm filling it with other things. I'm filling it with my own, the things that make me feel good, but not the things that are pleasing to God and pleasing to the relationship. So at the end of the day, I'm still empty. So I think that is so important. And as much as our mental health is super important, and I love that you talked about therapy, because I think sometimes in church, people just over spiritualize it and say, God is your therapist. Yes and no, right? You know, we do have to work on our own mental health. We do have to, just like we have to eat food, literally, you know, to sustain ourselves and survive. We do need to worry about that mental part, but we cannot neglect the spiritual part. You know, and I think that's a point where I was at. I was neglecting it. I was treating it as a sideshow to the main show, which was me.
I'm hearing you, Sean, 100%. And you know what the craziest thing is, I think, is that I think whilst I was out there, and you know, the scripture that comes to mind, or maybe the idea, the story that comes to mind, is prodigal son. One of the things that always confused me about the prodigal son is that he was already in the house. And it always just confused me. Why is he already in the house, knowing how good the house is, to want to go outside the house? How can you go outside the house when you know the house is banging already? Right? And that is literally the epiphany of one of the things that